episode is all about one of the most iconic drummers ever, Steve Gadd. Art of Drumming is not just a YouTube channel, but also a free platform where you can find numerous drum-related courses filmed by major international artists. Head on over and join our growing community. When you talk about characteristic drum sounds and legendary drummers, you have to mention Steve Gadd. He's best known for his incredible credit list, including artists like Eric Clapton, Chick Corea, Paul Simon, and Steely Dan. Just to name some of the most famous examples. When Yamaha Europe offered us the chance to film a video using his original European touring kit, we didn't hesitate for a single second. So big thanks to Yamaha, and let's get started by listening to one of the most iconic recordings with Steve Gadd on the drums, Steely Dan's song Asia. Start by unpacking and setting up the drums. His recording custom setup consists of 10, 12, 14, and 16-inch toms and a 20-inch bass drum. One thing that sticks out immediately is the riser for the 20-inch kick drum. This helps to make the beater hit the drum head right in the center instead of slightly above. The snare drum that came with the kit is a 14x5.5 recording custom steel model. Today, Gadd usually plays single-ply coated ambassador heads on the toms and power stroke 3 heads on the snare and bass drum. The rack toms are tuned pretty high and the floor toms rather low. Let's quickly check out the sound right out of the cases, captured with two large diaphragm overheads and an M88 for the kick drum. If you compare the tom sound to what you've heard before with Asia, you'll notice that the sound changed a lot and that the kit sounds a lot more open now than it did with the Steely Dan record. This is why we decided that if we want to recreate the original sound, we have to change the heads and go with a different approach. The snare and bass drum, however, work pretty well. The Power Stroke 3 head on the snare has a quite dead sound, and the bass drum with some muffling inside the shell has a short and warm quality that is already close to the Asia sound. While we kept the tuning of the bass drum almost the same, we tuned the snare up and also tightened the reso head. This is the snare tuning for Asia. If you listen to the toms on Asia, you'll notice a pretty punchy and short sound with a lot of low end. A great way to achieve a similar sound is to convert your toms into concert toms by simply removing the reso head and going for clear batter heads. For this song, we chose pinstripe clear heads for controlled overtones and a nice and crisp attack. A huge part of his sound on Asia also is muffling. To get the toms to be even shorter, we tape paper tissues to each of the toms and the snare. This is an old trick to quickly create a dead sound. So now let's see how all these treatments change the sound of the kit, once again with only overheads and a kick drum mic. That's a lot closer to the classic sound of the Steely Dan song from 1977. The cymbals we used for this video are his exact setup that you can check out on Zildjian's website. The hi-hat is a combination of a 14-inch K Constantinople bottom and a 14-inch A custom top. From left to right, the three other cymbals are an 18-inch K Dark Crash Thin, an A Zildjian Classic Orchestral Selection Medium Light as a ride cymbal, and a 20-inch K Constantinople Medium Thin Ride Low. Especially the combination of the different hi-hat cymbals and the orchestral cymbal as a ride make clear how much Gadd cares for his sound and that he really put some time into finding the perfect setup for himself. Now that we have the drums and cymbals in place, it's time to bring in some more mics. We looked at many of the videos you can find with Gadd on the drums and decided to go with some of the classics that you can see in most of those scenarios. For the toms, we used four Sennheiser MD421s. If you want to recreate some older tom sounds, this is the exact mic you need. Another all-time favorite is the snare top mic, a Shure SM57. For the snare bottom, we went with a Biodynamic M201. It soon became clear that we want to add a second mic for the bass drum for some more low end, so we placed a Biodynamic MC740 close to the reso head, changed the M88 we had before to an M201 for some more mid frequencies, and also moved the mic further into the porthole for a very clear attack. The overheads are large diaphragm condenser MC840s, and we added an MC950 for the hi-hat and an MC930 to support the ride cymbal in the mix. Now that we have the full kit set up, the only thing missing is a pair of Steve Gadd's signature sticks. Here is Pascal's version of Asia by Steely Dan. The level of dedication Gadd puts into creating grooves, fills, and also his drum sound is outstanding and makes him one of the greatest drummers ever. The influence he's had on the whole drumming world is immense, and being able to create a video with his original kit was a great experience for all of us. How do you like our version of his legendary sound, and how did his drumming influence you yourself? Share your thoughts in the comments and check out all the other episodes you can already find on our channel.